excited we are to have an audience. Your students have worked so hard in so many different ways, and tonight is such a celebration of all that they've done. Of last year, of this year, and how far they've come, how much they've made it through, and how musical they are, and how creative they are. And that's one of the exciting things. So as a parent, I want you to listen for a couple things tonight. One, listen for the technique. How hard they're working to play at the top of the level of their instrument, at the top of the range of their instrument, and the low range of their instrument. Listen to how they're blending. There are sounds that are not sticking out anymore. You can hear them listening to other people and making sure that their sound is a cohesive whole. And it's fantastic that their rhythms are complex, that their harmonies are really intricate, and they're doing a really good job of conveying what the artist and the composer wants them to be able to do. And that's the exciting part of tonight. So I want you to enjoy all of those things tonight. We have a whole wide variety of things, our whole wide variety of pieces for you tonight that shows the breadth and depth of what they're able to do and what they were able to learn over the course of this year. We hope you enjoy.
The depth and breadth is the key for this next piece, mainly depth of meaning. This piece is entitled Bloom, which has ramifications for mental health awareness. Katie Shimura is the composer that we actually have a relationship with at our school. She has been here in the past, and we have premiered her music, and she's stayed at Ms. Tyke's house during a snowstorm. And it's just a beautiful person, and writes music that is really just hits the soul of these musicians, I think. And this is a time where we're all finding we're slowly emerging from a pretty dark place, and we're able to finally enjoy live concerts. We're enjoying each other's company and hugs, and that's what this is about, is that blooming of opening up and coming out of the darkness. This is Bloom.
Thank you. Brianna Brotherson, and the next piece we'll be playing for you is The Entertainer by Scott Joplin.
Hello, my name is Isabel Durbach, and one thing that we all really liked about this piece is the very timely tempo. It all made us feel like we were going to dance.
One thing we worked really hard on with this piece was getting the tempo up to speed and making sure we played all the staccatos correctly so we could bring the piece together through articulations.
One thing that was really challenging to us was the rhythms and staying together as a man. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy this piece of music.
Thank you.
after we have a video that has all of the amazing things that your students did over the course of the year, pep band and jazz too, and concerts in the park. And they did all of those things. They're just not on video. And so usually we have a little bit of that end of the year video and a little bit of our senior video. And this evening we combined all of them today. Some of these students have seen this earlier in the band banquet, but what I wanted to give you an opportunity to see what the year looked like in a couple of different perspectives, but also to hear what it was like to complete 4 years of band and make sure that they got all the way to the end. And so this is a celebration of exactly that.
Looking extra fly for the day I die. I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly for the day I die. I'ma touch the sky. Back when he thought his toe was a hurt to ride before it came back. Must be heaven. I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Let's take them high.
It's okay, they're getting good, like I said. waves and sound it. And just say whatever, cause there is no way you're grounded. And everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay.
Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you.
you can see there's lots of really fun things that happen, and a lot of students talk about the band trip and the other things that they've been involved in over the course of their 4 years. So a couple things that we just want you to be aware of. We've sent out a couple pieces of communication, and we're already starting to fill up lots and lots of spots for the trip to New Orleans next year. But if you still would like some more information, I have paper copies out with Heather Samuelson back here on the booster table, and she would love to have you, I'd love to give it out to you. If you still want to get in on that and talk about it or turn your forms in, we're happy to receive it. It's just fine, and we're not going to turn in a final, the final initial deposit until next week. So there's lots of times for questions and lots of times to get your registration form in. The other thing is that we know that lots of students are searching for summer activities. They just need something else to get out and in person and to do. And we launched a new summer band initiative. It's very fun. It has lots of clinicians, lots of people from all over the colleges and universities nearby coming into play. It'll be mixed grade level. It's just a week. There's a summer jazz band and a summer concert band for 9th through 12th graders. We also have one for 5th through 6th graders and 5th through 8th graders. So if that's something that applies to your family, all of the registration information is out on the community webpage. But Heather also really has a great QR code that you can click and figure out where to register for. So we'd love to have you a part of those two things. The other thing that I would say is that some of your students have talked a little bit about summer health and PE. If that's something that they want to do, confirm with them that they've received the email. Confirm with them that they've received the email. That's really crucial. And then if they're confused or they think that they got something different or they don't know what to do, ask a few more questions and we can help. But we can't help if we didn't know that they didn't get it because they didn't know that they needed it. So one of the options for 10th grade scheduling is to put health and PE in the summer. And it's a great, fantastic thing that Spring Lake Park does to make sure that students can do both music and a foreign language. And we're so glad that they do it. But there's always a scheduling crunch. And so if we need to assist a little bit with your scheduling crunch, we're really good at it. But we have to know that you need it. Yes, make sense? Great.
Time for more music. So we were part of a consortium of that went around Minnesota schools that that commissioned a bunch of Black American composers to write music after the events in Minneapolis with the death of George Floyd. And this is one of the pieces that we're about to perform. And how it resonates with students is that it talks about when something happens that's big and confusing, that there's multiple emotions hitting us at one time. And how do you do that? How do you have this anger over here and this excitement over here and that's inside of you at once? So this piece is called The Joy That Comes, and that's what it talks about, is this two that can happen to you, and that can happen to a teenager, that can happen to an adult, just like and how do you unpack two different polar opposite ways of feeling at once? So this is called The Joy That Comes by Esau Jones.
Thank you. I'm Andrew Weefel, and our band has put together an amazing brass group with our percussionist, Caleb. We'll play one song today, and the song makes all of the parts distinct, which makes it one of my favorites. We now present to you the Boogie Blues.
Inside of a clock. You can hear all of the staccatos and you can hear all the articulations. The articulations were one of my favorite things to work on with this piece with Mr. Wolf and Ms. Tycast. Please enjoy this piece.
Thank you.
much for coming this evening. If there's anything that you heard, had questions about, want to shoot us an email, please feel free. Mr. Wolf and I are trying to be really available to answer any questions, whether it be about tour or scheduling or registration, showcase, anything that's going to happen over the next couple weeks or months. We'd love for your students to be involved. Additionally, if you are interested in being a parent volunteer with the Band Boosters, Heather Samuelson and Heidi Sass are our two booster board members, and they're looking for more volunteers all the time. Many hands might make light work, but I think the work is kind of fun. But that's because it's great, and it helps your students. But we've had a really great time this year. Both Mr. Wolf and I often say that this is one of the best jobs. Sometimes it's the hardest job, but it's one of the best jobs in the world. We get to know your students over the course of 4 years and make music with them every day, and it's such a powerful experience. Next piece of music, or our last piece of music, is The Golden 13 by Timothy Lost. It celebrates the commissioning of Black Naval officers into the United States.